Hello everybody, welcome to the webinar. Myself, I'm currently working as a data scientist at IBM. So the today's topic would be object detections. So to go forward, what is object detection? We want to detect object. So how is the difference between a classification, localization, and segmentation? You can see from the chart. So first part is, let us say if an image is given. So we classify, we have a model whether it's a cat or a dog or what is it. We do describe the picture. Next is, what is classification plus localization? Localization means if given a cat picture is given. So it says it is cat and it draws a bounding box where the cat is there. That is why you are locally saying that this part of the image holds the cat. So next, what is object detection? Object detection is classification plus localization and multi-object. If you notice over here, there is multi-classifying. Classification happening and there is multiple bounding box which is drawn. Cat, dog, duck, and everything. So next forward is going forward is segmentation.
So let's not into that topic. So
we understood what is classification and localization. So we'll see, since you guys are all from ML background, I would tell where it started, how it started. So image classification, first it started with CNN, which is convolutional neural network. So it started from that way. First object detection is, so what is the general case I would say for object? We would say is face detection basically. You know that like our cameras, video cams, those and all. If you notice over here, video recording something, automatically a bounding box starts appearing on your face. Those and all. So it's not running any model or it's not doing some AI at all. How is it that? It is a mind base. There is no AI at all in that. That is the statistical model, how it is used. I would tell you. So the most general case is face data. So face data, how do you detect faces? One of the algorithms which is used is Weyler-Jones algorithm. So what is Weyler-Jones algorithm? It is a statistical technique where which can detect a face basically. So okay, directly to go without going into Weyler-Jones, I would start like with convolutional neural network. How does a machine understands images basically? You are seeing some images over here, but how does it understand? How does machine understand? Okay. So machine understands through convolutional neural network. So I'll take a small example. The very basic example is, let's see. So I'll start with classification. So detection is classification plus localization. So I'll start with classification. Let us say two images are given. So one is X, another is O. We are going to detect the image is nothing. I have set of X's, set of Y. I have to detect whether it is X or Y. That's obviously. How this will happen? So you know images are nothing but set of pixels. So the color images are nothing but RGB, red, green, and blue. So how much red quantity is there, how much green quantity is there, how much blue quantity is there. Combination will give you the image. Let us think we have a black and white image. Purely black and white. How X will be represented? So this is the image. Okay. I am taking a 4x4 matrix. So the resolution of the image is 4x4. We normally see this is 1024x1024. I am taking a very small image. Think about it, is just 4x4 pixels of it. How X will be represented? So this can be X. So okay, I'll take this as X. And this is -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1, -1. you don't understand anything over here, I know. Okay, just okay, minus one is black. Plus one is white.
It's why just zero instead of answer. Answer of answer is negative zero.
Black and white images, it will be minus one is black, plus one is white. Okay. So you can understand over here. If you see over here, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So this is x. Understood? Got the point, right? This is x. So just visualize how this will look in a pixel. Okay. So this is how. So well, what it has to understand, how the machine understands is the filter size. So it understands through filters. So what are the parameters which can take over this? Let us say I am taking a filter of some 4 plus 4. Okay. So
2 plus
2. Oh sorry, 2 plus 2. Thank you. 2 plus 2. What are the possibilities? We see, if you notice over here, we understand that in this part you have 1 and 1. So this is a feature, diagonal feature.
Which part you have that part? Which part there you have?
This is x on android.
No. That I understood.
This is x.
Which slice of this particular string you have on it? You said 4 by 4,
right? Okay, fine. So how this works, I'll tell you. Filters. So when you have a 2 cross 2 map, 2 cross 2 filters, so what are the combinations? This can be complete white, minus 1, minus 1, 1, 1. What is it? It's white and black. Vertical image. Next is, what is the other combination? This one, black and white, or sine combination. 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1. Okay, next is, what is the other combination? It can be a diagonal. 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1. You're getting the point, understood? So these are the combinations which can occur in 2 cross 2. So what this detects, if you notice over here, so this is 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1. That means, if you are seeing over here, this is black. So there is a filter which is white and black. So what is this used for? This is used for x detection. So it is seeing where are the positions where there is a transition from black to white. Black to white. So later image.
What is image?
Function F11.
Yeah.
I maximize the screen.
Okay, see the image. Sorry. Okay, how this can be used? One second. So this is the black one, black and white image. So what is the thing work? First I'm identifying what are the edges. Notice very minute. If you see over there is a transition from white and black. Can you see? So and this is the edge. So that one, that filter is used to identify this edge. Okay. That's what it is. Next is so this edge can be straight or it can be horizontal or it can be this one diagonal. Understood? So the curvature is not, if you are saying like there are, the edge can be curved also. Curved is nothing but addition of all the three parameters. So there are only three parameters: horizontal, vertical, and diagonal. So those three filters are used over here. So and how edge is being detected? I'll tell you. Let us say we are picking up a horizontal edge. Horizontal edge is a picture which is having here basically. What are the lines of horizontal lines which are present inside a picture? Understood? You got the point?
No.
No? Okay. Now I'll show you this. Four is there. How you would be seeing like how zero is represented in the LED panel, pixel wise. So it will be like this. Understood? This is how O will be represented in an image, 4 plus 4 image. When you are going for higher resolution, this will become a pure O. When you are zooming and they are viewing in a very small resolution, it will be seen like this. So, let us say, if I want to detect this, I have to detect this one, horizontal parts. I have to detect
vertical paths. I have to drill a diagonal path. The combination of all three parameters will give O. Understood? So now using the first curve, first filter, which I am detecting only these two. The top and top. Understood? How this can be done? This can be done through convolution. So in back, this one basic mathematics, you would have what is convolution. You have an idea of what is convolution? Okay, fine. So convolution.
Convolution theory.
Yeah. Convolution. Mathematics convolution.
Yeah.
So
convolution is convolution.
Okay, my way you can say convolution is nothing but the matrix multiplication. So let us say my kernel is this. So what is this kernel? I am detecting the horizontal edge. So this is the horizontal edge I'm taking. 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1. Understood? So I am finding where are the factors. Okay, fine. This it will be no useful. I will take the. I'm taking the x over here. So x, if you see over here, there is a diagonal line. So I am detecting what are, where are the diagonal elements with this person. I didn't take horizontal line because there is no horizontal line person over here. So I will not give a proper value. So I thought I will take this one. Understood? So let us do convolution. So basically, what is a convolution is? Convolution is a, you can say, a repetitive multiplication of matrix. You know multiplication of a matrix. Matrix A cross B, A into B is matrix. The matrix multiplication. Matrix multiplication, you can see that the this one, we just multiply and you get another matrix. But in convolution, you do repetitive wise multiplication. That means this filters, this is the image. So if this image is being passed over here, so let us take an image. Just here's an X or I'll take an X one. Yes.
Don't do the X and double X, man.
Fine,
probably this is going to be good. I do agree. So fine. So we are detecting X over here.
Okay. If you see the filter, my filter is this is the filter. Okay. Diagonal. So this one is positive. This is my filter.
What is filter in this case?
Filter is a part of image. You can say. So when you deconvolve this, when X is being deconvolved. What will happen? It will be if let this plus this plus this plus this. Understood? When you do deconvolution is splitting the image into basic parameters.
So basic components will be these.
These are the components. If you add all four, you get X. Understood? How this can be done? This, 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 this. If you add all three, you will get O. Understood? So what we have to do, we have to classify or we have to find where are the parameters, where are these parts of the image are present. Understood? All four. Basically. So this is my first process. I am choosing this. We are choosing the horizontal line. Where are the horizontal line present over here? So how a convolution happens is we take this slant line, diagonal line, we move over X. We move from starting from the top part. Is there a slant line present? We keep moving, we keep moving, we keep moving every single pixel on even the side. Just think that the slant line is moved over the complete image. And we are finding out where and how the slant line or the diagonal part is present. Okay, if I would ask for an X to be present over here, this line has to be present how many times?
Four times.
this line, this part of the filter. So, this part, if I'm using this part of filter, I should get output as this. Correct? That is split into two. I should get two diagonal lines. Correct? Got the point? If I'm taking this filter, I should get these two. Understood? So let's hover over now. Now I have space, right?
Okay, I'll get that.
So when I do convolution currently, so convolution will become just okay. I'm taking what is the value of the cell for the convolution. This part is taken and kept over here. First thing from the point from here to here, 2 cross 2. So this part is merged over here. And you can multiply 1, 1, -1, -1. So this could be -1. 1, -1, -1, 1. When kept over here, 1, -1, -1, 1. These two are multiplied and added. So 1 into -1, -1 into -1. So do addition. -1 into 1. -1. Then after that, what is this?
-1.
This is 1. Yeah, this is minus. -1 into -1 is 1. +1. And -1 into -1 is. So how much is this? -2. Yeah, cool. -2, I guess. And again, you move over here. So it will become 1, -1.
-1.
Okay. You're getting the point, right? 1 into 1 will become 1. -1 into -1 will become +1. -1 into -1 will become +1. 1 into 1 will become 1. 4. You're getting 4 over here. Okay. 1
plus
why?
Yeah. How do you choose that 2 plus 3 quantity? Less of 4 means?
Less of 2.
It can be anything, it can be anything plus 3 also.
It's a hyperparameter.
It's a hyperparameter.
The size of the kernel weight printer is a hyperparameter.
I'm taking the very less deconvolution in this case.
If you want microscopic features, go 0N, you choose a smaller printer. If you want a larger view,
I'll tell you. Okay, simple. Something you have to classify this. How many, if I deconvolute into this, this, and this, how many parts will be there? There will be 1000 when you do deconvolution. Understood? There will be 1000. So, when there are 1000, still you handle with these parameters. Instead of this, when I take a 3 cross 3 matrix, I can take a new feature which is having something like this. Understood? You're getting the point. I'm going in the very basic way. Very narrowing into very minute pixel. These are the minute pixels. When you, let us say, there is a horizontal line, there is a slant line. When you add this to what will happen? When you add horizontal line and this, you get kind of this. Understood? When you add this and this, what will happen? You will get like this something. You got it? So, these curves are not ready. You don't want to classify an image just from the basic part, but you want to classify two curves and up, you go for higher contrast. You go for 3 cross 3, you go for 5 cross 5, but we have only 4 cross 4 matrix. So let's go on a nice way to understand what convolution happens. I am taking only 2 cross 4 matrix.
So the answer is what easy for us to understand. So we are starting with the very, very basic.
Yes, very basic. That's why I started with the SN only, SN 0. I didn't start with cat and dog. To understand the fact. So this keeps on going. So when convolution happens, every single parameter goes. If you notice over here, your X is over here. Right? So probably what they are taking this filter. So this filter, if we are getting a diagonal image, so for diagonal image for this filter, it should give an output of this. So where this slant line present in the image, it is present same the pixel, you will get high values over here. Because these three lines or these three pixels has one part of S, which belongs to the slant line. Understood? Understood the point, right? So the 4, 4, 4 you will get over here. Apart from that, every year some negative or a low value you will be getting in the other part of the image. Understood? So we detected this line or a okay, the left slant line.
We can detect a line, let's say an X from here on itself. When we have a combination of let's say 3, 1 in diagonal way, we can detect it here also, right? So why are we multiplying? And there are 3 ones, right?
When you see a cat for the images.
No, I mean,
I understand. When you have one single class, you have to detect only X, whether there is X present or not. How your model will be there? Whenever you find there is a pattern of 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, it is X. Right?
Right.
Okay. You are having two classes currently right now. You have to know what are the differences between X and O. When an image has a point, right?
In that case, at least we can go with that, what I'm saying.
So if you want to know that, that's the inference condition. The same matrix, when you give it in the inference matrix, you say that, let us say, this this pixel has one, this pixel has one, this pixel has one, and these one three have one, there it is X. Inference condition. But X can be here, it can be here, it can be here, it can be here, anywhere.
Okay,
and X can be like this also. How your inference condition will predict this? Understood? Given this is X. Now you want to understand it is X.
In that case also we will be able to do that.
Convolution. Right. So convolution comes here.
Okay. So with the help of convolution we will be able to predict it even X.
So it is not pure X. Instead of predicting the complete X, we are predicting into splitter splits.
So, you know, this is the face. So, we started with the face, right? This is the eye, right? Where say this is the face. It's not as well as so, there is a pixel here. There is a pixel here. You see? So this is depth. This is depth. Where say the eye has some depth. So, this pixel is this is white. So, I am looking at two pixels. This is black minus 1, this is 1. So the line pixel and the surrounding pixel. So I multiplied kernel filter having this shape. So when you multiply these two pixels by this kernel filter, what will happen? The output will be 1 into 1 plus minus 1 into minus 1 is equal to 2. So that means the result of this will be one pixel which has 2. 2 is high value. High value means non. So there is some intelligence. So we got the line. Right? We got the line. Now let's assume there is a pixel here and the same filter I applied to these two pixels. Right? So this is white, right? So 1, 1, I multiply with the same kernel. 1 minus 1, what will happen? 1 into minus 1 plus 1 into minus 1. So this becomes minus 2. So this starts going negative. This is positive. You see, so it finds because this is positive, that means there is a line here, this is negative, there is nothing. Got the point? And high degree of positivity, high degree of negativity. There is nothing here. But there is a line here because highly positive.
So the higher the number you get, that means higher correlated or higher possibility that it is there. That kind of feature is present over here. So that is why you will be 4, 4, 4 over here. So then again, when you are doing this feature, so when this feature is given over here, then again it will become 4 cross 4 cross 4. Sorry, 4, 4, 4 in this line. So this one model understands that. Let us say if there is a combination of 4, 4, 4 and there is a 4, 4, 4 over here. But That is what is convoluted. So when we stack up this image and this image, when we stack both the images, you get x.
The 4s and the minus 4s will come in the x factor.
So you will get minus 4s. This will be 0.
We had a mistake here. This is 1 and minus 1. See, this is 1 and 1, right? This is 1 and minus 1. So 1 into 1 plus 1 into minus 1 is 0. 0. So 0 means there is nothing here. And non zero value means there is something here. This is what is happening. That's what is happening for the x also.
So, since this is 1 and minus 1. Let us say there is another pixel which is minus 1 and 1. So there is a transition, the transition from black to white. What will be the value for this?
Minus.
Understood, right? So when you, so our filter is, we are checking for a transition from white to black. So whenever there is a white to black transition, or you got a point, right?
So it will be non-zero for a line and zero for when there is no
transition. Exactly. So when there is white to black transition, you will get a positive value. When there is a black to white transition, you will get a negative value.
Right.
Values of this, if you take a ball, you will get a high value. Wherever there is no filter at all. So in this part there is white and white, there is no transition at all. So there you will get 0 values.
So that pixel will become 0. The result of that will become 0.
So that is why this line will be minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. Which means There is a feature which is a slant line, but it is in the opposite way. This, there is the opposite way. So there is a negative part in neutral lenses. So we understood, right? You got to understand how exactly the convolution happens. Okay, let's go for Euler terms. So what are the Euler terms? So I'll take the image of this one. So if you notice over here, Euler terms is an algorithm which is used to detect faces. Okay. So as per the faces, we know the algorithm. Like, so now the edges can be horizontal, vertical, or slant. Okay. I'm taking a knife based of a face. So faces, you know that this is knife. So this is also eye. This is nose. So nose will be something like this. Okay, and this one. So
your nose?
yeah. How well comes? Let's take this image. Okay. So how well comes happens is same thing. It detects the black to white transition. From whether it is a vertical transition or a horizontal transition or a slant transition. If you notice from the image over here, the eyes are darker as compared to other part. So there is an eyebrow over here. Black to white transition is there. So you will get positive values here. So that's one feature. So for a face, the eyebrows, the black to white transition should be there. Present two times. Black to white transition. At the vertical level, it should be present two points. So let us see what is the horizontal transition. So horizontal transition means white to black in a horizontal way. If you see, notice a nose over here. Nose, the front part, this is white, this is black. Understood? So there is a transition of white to black. So the image, the model will say that if there is a transition of white to black once in center, in the vertical way, there is a transition of white to black, then it is a face. What is the other part? Other part is, there can be other filter also. You have like three posterior, right? So what if there is a transition of white, black to white? Let us take the nose itself. Nose will be black, white, black. It's not black, but it is a shade of black. There is a transition. You can find the transition of black to white over here, right? So that kind of matrix can be used over here. So there is a transition of black, white, black. Here you see, white, black, white in the eyes. So detection of eyes. Eyes can be detected when there is a transition of white to black, then black to white twice. Okay, you got the point?
So these are the parameters. Even the ellipse, if you see, black to white to black, these are considered to be white. And the ellipse at all is red. So red is a contrast. If you take it in the black, then it will become somewhere gray. So gray to white to gray. If you see over there, that is the transformation. Okay, this is how it happens. Well,
sir, something I have assumed.
Yeah, sure.
Say let us assume, for example, our face is like half covered. Still, the features are valid.
Half covered.
Maybe half.
So
covered.
It is while it doesn't work.
Because two eyebrows, two, I mean, a transition.
See, okay, I'll take a simple example. See, wireless jumps algorithm is applied to our phones, video cameras, everything. If you stand straight in front of video camera, then only you will detect the surface. If you stand like this, and then you will not detect. Maybe the advanced cameras over here are already trained with a different example, saying that don't just, the person can have one eye also. So if you turn over here, the image will be one eye. That's all. So what it can, the model will be trained such that saying that this is the half face. Even this, there can be a face in a other alignment. That's what is all.
So you need training data.
Yes.
Let's say half face is covered. Training data and those kind of faces, people learn. But if training data did not have half
face. Not in the wireless. It's not deep learning.
Not in this one, but overall machine learning.
It is machine learning. It is a base. So our phones and all is not deep learning models. It's a base statistical model or machine learning model, which is used. It's directly said that there is a transmission of -1, -1, -1, -1, that is I. So there is two next to next transition is there. So these two are I's. Then it is a face. If you notice on your phone camera, if you have some smiley ball or something like that, even that will be digital transmission. Very old cameras. Now it is advanced. Our phone cameras is good.
See, one problem in face detection would be even if I is on the cheek, it will still mark it as face.
So localization doesn't come into view. Yeah. So let us go forward to Euler zones. So okay, that's what I was speaking about. Rectangle. So there is a transition from white to black in horizontal way, vertical way, and there can be a transition of this white, black, white. So these are the filters which are used for face detection in a nine way. So this all is how it will be confirmed. So they are not using convolution in this case. They are using direct mathematics. This will go deep. Okay, I'll tell you what. How their mathematics advances, it is not convolution. If this kind of pixel is given over here, they create integral images. Integral images where if I'm taking this value is equal to, okay, this value will be this. Let us say this value. This value will be equal to sum of this one. This value will be equal to sum of these two. If you are taking this value, then this value is sum of all four. That is the integral. So if you notice over here, integral image, the first xy. Xy is equal to xy. But if you are taking the fourth pixel over here, it is the sum of all four. Understood? So you guys know integration, right? Integration is the sum of pixels, or sum of anything. That is integration. So integral images, you are doing a summation of the pixels to get the values. So what this happens is, why it is used is, let us say I want a convolution of the center part. What is the value or the area of this center part? So you will get that from the integral part. So this is not convolution, this is statistical way of finding out.
So this would be slightly an older.
Very, very old.
Compared to CNNs, right, sir?
Very, very old. What happens is, let's say this is the summation of the pixel is nothing but -1. But for this, it will be 1 - 1, which is 0. For this, -1, -1, which is -2. For this one, it will be -1, -3, plus
which is minus 2.
Understood? Let us say,
okay, this will be it.
So I want to find out what is the sum of these two values. So I want to know what is the I want to detect this one. So I want from the ethical language we can directly calculate. Okay, the minus 1 plus 0 will give directly give you the summation of these two pixels.
Understood?
Okay, fine. I want the summation of this box. What is the area of this box? You have this point as one pixel, A. This point as another pixel, which is C and D. From the integral image, A is the summation of this whole. Understood? Correct? Got the point? B is the sum of these, this box. Integral image. D of this box. C is the summation of this part. Understood? So if I want to calculate this value, you can directly A, which is a big box, whole box minus this part minus this part will give you this value. Understood the why integral image is used over here? So that is one. A minus B, which is this, minus C, which is this, plus D, because this part we have to, this part gets added twice in B and C. So you are right. Understood the point, right? So that's why integral image is used. So that is all of this. Rest all is, if you can see over here, this is the image of the face. So there is a transition of, if you notice, eyes is black as compared to the face. So there is a transition of black to white, and if you see the nose, there is a transition of black to white to black.
So what was the use of calculating that area? I wanted how to get the area. What was the advantage of calculating that area?
It is similar to convolution, where you get a set of numbers. So it's, see, even in a convolution, you will get 4, 4, 4, minus 4, minus 4, minus 4, right? So, in an integral image, for this part of, let us say I want the value of this dabba. Okay. Okay, this part of image, the eye image. So, integral image will give you some part of values. It can be 1, 1, 1, 1, 2, some 3, 3, 3. Yeah. So, this part, this image will be understood by the computer, by those features. Integral image is the summation of all the pixels you get.
Yeah, this
continuous summation.
No,
this is convolution.
Okay.
Convolution you forget. This is integral, which is used by wireless. That is right. What this says is how much is each pixel compared to the other pixels. So that is right. What you said is integral. So this means that it is black. This pixel is black. This pixel is, there is a transition. If you see over here, minus 1 plus 1, which is 0. 0, there is a transition happening. When there is minus 2, there is a negative transition which is happening. Minus 1 to minus 1. That means the black is going to black again. So you get a negative part. When black is going to white, you get a 0. When black is moved to a, here, if you see over there.
Okay, no, so this is nothing but a continuous sum of adjacent cells.
Not only adjacent. If you compare over here, just all four. Left, right, top, everything.
Let's say even if minus 1, minus 2, 2, minus 1, still the shade is getting lighter compared to the more black. It's like
it's kind of a histogram. If you notice, if you just take this image and keep it into your head, histogram, it will show intensity, colorness.
Yeah, heat map actually.
You have seen heat maps of our images and all that. That you get RGB. That is the image which is put into mappers. So even in cameras and all, you will be getting a histogram of RGB of an image.
Okay.
So in a black and white, you will get as a matrix. That's right. So that's how it finds.
But one thing, is it something that everything, whatever filters we have to find out those filters, or it is available somewhere in some basics? Let's say here we have to find out that whether the image has black color or white color. Now I have to find out that if it is
a black. So features are nothing but slant, vertical, and horizontal.
Even for
any object. Any object. It is a combination of these three.
Okay.
Right?
So all, I mean,
all the options
will be, for all pictures it will be like same is what I'm trying to understand. Three pictures.
It's just lines in an image. Either line is this, or maybe or just find it.
Yeah.
Only three kinds of.
So line. Nothing. See, when you micro or do a micro imaging of a big image, it has features will be horizontal blur line, vertical line, or it will be a slant line.
But everything on the face is a. Is a combination of lots of
lines.
Definitely. That is a deep learning. So, when you go. That's what I said, right? When you add slant and straight, it becomes a curve. So, when
it may not be a straightforward curve, it would not be a straightforward curve, but a little bit similar like a curve.
Okay, now just highlight.
See, one minute. So, O, which is represented in a zoomed way, will be this. So, O is nothing but a combination of these three parameters. Just look at it. So, yeah,
straight. Okay. You see, Abdul is standing in front of you. So, zoom in on Abdul, you only see his face. If you widen that lens, then you see the entire Abdul. That's what he's trying to say.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'll tell you simple, maybe a little different opportunity. So, like, so the image, right? So we'll have a pixel black and white. So first they detect dot. So they detect white pixel is 0. As means from -1, you will make 0. These are white. These are a dot. Then you can find as a this. Then you can find as a edge. Then you can find as a line. Then you can use a 2 lines to make a box. Or you can use multiple like ops or end, we can use like this to make find a circle. So,
this is a pixel.
So, you want to detect the face in the images. This one face. Assuming this is face. Assuming like that. So, you want to detect the face. The images. So we have to use a computer. We can use by using that by several pixels in computer or pixel. By using the pixel, by using pixel only we can find. So by using pixel, we can find line. So using computational algorithm, that's using features, that's using filter. Using filter, we can find a line, edges, or rectangle, or circle. That's another to find out that if that's a given image, that's a given image. In this image, there's a line or not. Still, we want to tell you one more thing. What is computer vision is? It's the opposite of the computer graphics. The computer graphics, what you do? So, you want to draw a face, what you do? You draw a circle. You want to draw a small circle. You want to draw a small circle. You want to draw a small rectangle. So in computer graphics, what you draw, you are drawing on the computer. So through paint or anywhere. So in what is computer vision is opposite of, or you can say inverse of computer graphics. But the given image, so graphics you are drawing, computer vision you are finding there is a circle, rectangle, corner, edges,
computer graphics, you have vision, computer vision, you are trying to find out what are the line, circle, dot, or thick lines are present. So this is the way we are doing. So that's why using the filter. By using filter, we can find the line, edges, corner, edges, boundary, anything you can find. So this is also with this human face. So in human face, we have a lot of features. So how do you say this human face? So you have two eyes, one eyebrow, one nose, and mouth, and it should be circle. Assume it's a normal circle. So you have to use spine. You have to find out that there is also a mapping formula is that there is a distance from this side to this side, some distance is there. You cannot eye, you cannot like itself. You should be some distance between the eye. From eyes to nose also, there is some distance, and nose to mouth also, some distance is there. So that's using some features. There are set up offset values that we can. So what you have to do? So there is a class, there is called Arabost. It's called Arabost class value, you should say. So you have to find the places, you have to find the other pairs find the circle. Then you have to find this is a rectangle present in the images. Then you have to find two rectangles. Then you have to find that the rectangle is in a vertical way. Then it's other rectangle. In the other block, there will be small lines there. These are all parallel pixels in the given image, is called as face. Somebody?
Cool, fine. So, fine. Classification you understood, right? The statistical way of doing classification is using the Euler zones. Euler zones use the integral image classification. It finds an image, common image, it finds a histogram of that image. On the histogram, it can
show that mathematical equation to add some of these lines, but it shows for 10 seconds.
10 seconds?
Yeah, I don't know what we talk
about.
Why the transfer?
So this is not, this is not CNNs.
No, these are not CNNs.
This is better. Well.
No,
let's
get better.
But basically, it says that there is a transition of void of that. That's what the tweets call it. Okay, fine. You are the statistical way, right? So, statistical way is nothing but vertical lines, horizontal lines, and when you are moving to some, you are classifying a dog or cat, then it is not made of flat or so, that those features will be thousands. So, if I say, detect all the vertical lines will be millions for a cat. And the slab lines for so that doesn't become redundant. So that's why what we do, there is a combination of all the features. I want to detect a circle. I have to detect a rectangle. What is a rectangle? Rectangle is a combination of horizontal, two vertical. So a circle, what is a circle? Circle is a combination of the tangents. You know how it works, right? So circle is an combination of a polygon. Basically, a circle is a polygon which has a tangents. You know, right? Understood. So these are the features. These features cannot be done through integral images. Will be very huge. So that's why we are taking convolution. So convolution, when you are using let us say the kernel matrix is fixed as like v cross v, 5 cross 5, 7 cross 7. It can detect multiple features. Multiple different features also it can detect through convolution. And it can be done in a very fast way. Understood? Okay, so let us go. Okay, now we know the image we have classified image to this one, whether it's a cat or a dog or an X or O. We classified it. Now we have to localize it. Localize it means where exactly the object is being present. So how do we do localizing? Localizing means we have to generate a box. So you have to generate a bounding box saying that this part of image. As this one. So how do we do it? So for that there are multiple algorithms. The basic way or the basic star algorithm would be RCNN. What is RCNN? We know CNN. What is a CNN? CNN is a neural network or algorithm used to classify an image. It is X or O or cat or dog. So that's all a CNN can do. But we can never say where the exact object is present. So, RCNN is nothing but region CNN. So, region CNN is what I'm doing.
So we say that it generates this box, bounding box, and it says there is a image in that. How do we generate that? Okay, this image is given over here. How RCNN works is, normally if you take kind of images, the object will be present in center, side, the side or this side, center, or it can be bottom or it can be top. Generally, I'm saying about any image. 90% or 80% if you consider, the image will be at the center. Or some, how do you take an image? How we take it? If I'm taking an image of him, I don't take it like this. Here then the object is not present. Or I don't put him in the, at the top corner and take a look. So by this motto, RCNN works. What RCNN works is, it generates random regions. If my image is there over here, random bounding boxes it generates. And most of the bounding boxes will be present in the center. Understood? You got the point? So the random boxes will be generated and will be generated, which is localized to the center. Because in the natural case, so most of the object will be present in the center. This is just assumptions, which is not right. So let us say that in case the neural network is given over here. So this region proposal is done over here. So this is the region, right? Boundary box are generated over here. So this is RCNN uses selective search. That means if the image is given over here, this region is and it is classified.
So it assumes prior region variance.
Correct. If this is the X image, I draw this part and give it to a CNN and say whether it is X or not. Understood? Instead of this whole image, I give it to a CNN. So that if this part understood it is something. So if this part is classified, that means this bounding box is right. But so RCNN works by randomly generating bounding boxes, and it is a selective search, randomly crop images and ask the CNN whether it is a right or not. So I am taking some three bounding boxes are taken. This is one bounding box, this one bounding box, this one bounding box. That is three crop images. These three crop images are given to CNN. Separately, it is given to CNN. And finally, it is asked whether it is X or not. So, it is asked whether it is X or O. X or O. X or O. This is saying I am X. For X, this bounding box will be fixed. If this is saying I am O, this bounding box is fixed for O. Understood, right? This is our representation of a search. Okay. Which is whether let us say this box is saying I am not either X or neither O. I am cropping this part of image. Which is nothing. So those bounding that bounding boxes are useless. Okay. So that's what it means. You got the point, right? How to generate the bounding boxes. So after the bounding boxes is there, so how the output will be there? I'll show you the output.
In one image, can you have multiple?
All correction is that. I'll tell you. I'm coming to that point. So this is object detection. This is not. So object detection is this. So this is what you are. It can be multiple objects. So if you notice over here, there are three crop images. I have a CNN and another is X or O. One part is one crop image is saying X, yes, other crop image is saying O, other crop is saying I am nothing. Got the point, right? So the one image there is X and O. So it's localizing these two.
not correct.
It's
not
correct. It's
localizing as CAM.
Localizing as CAM. Let's say that in one page it's CAM multiple CAMs. So it can be both called as X or X and
X. X. All X, but you will have multiple learning boxes. So if you notice over here, see at the top, cat, dog. So those are the X, but different learning boxes are generated for each object. So how the output will be there? Output is the first part. So Y matrix is this. So it starts from P0 or PC, you can say this is P. PC is the value whether it is cat or dog or nothing. Okay? So image can be cat or dog or nothing. Next would be, next is what are the learning boxes? Learning boxes is a rectangle. So rectangle is height and width only. What is the height and the width of the rectangle bounding box? And where the location, where the bounding box is placed? That is the position. Position which can be X and Y. You know? So, this is the bounding box. You have height and width. Okay. This is not simple. Forget about X1 and X2. So, X2, Y2 is height and width, you will just assume. Okay. So height and width is X and Y, in two variables. Apart from that, you have X and Y. Where this bounding box is present in the image. This is the image, right? So the bounding box, I am taking the center point. Center point of the bounding box is X and Y. So first I generate a rectangle with this height and this width. So where I get this bounding box, to this one, you need an X and Y coordinates. So I take the center of the rectangle. To X and Y. So this is how the bounding box is fixed. These are the points. Apart from that, what is C1, C2, C3, C4? C1 is the number of classes. X, Z, X and Y, there are two classes. So if it is X, it will be 1, 0. If it is 4, it will be 0, 1. And P0 is object exists or not. It will be 0 if it is a one. It will be 1 if it is a some object is present. So when P0 is 0, these values are useless. This will be any. This will not be calculated at all.
Good point. This dx1, dx2 are continuous.
Okay.
P is nothing but whether the object.
Okay. Why is dx1, dx2? Okay. This rectangle, you got it. How do you generate rectangle? It's 2 points. This generates. This is x1, x2, x1, y2. X1, Y1, X2, Y2. You have these 2 points. You can directly draw a rectangle when you have 2 points over there. So this algorithm uses X1, X2 and Y1, Y2. But now what is going on? Now the RCNN generating uses X1, which is the center point of the image. And what is the height and width of the rectangle?
Basically, you need 2 points, the X1 coordinates, and then you extrapolate this and
extrapolate. Exactly. That's what. So, okay, this is Y. You got the point, right? X is the image. Y is this output. When this output is being present, you will, by using these values, you generate a box and you give an output. So, this is X, this is Y. So, intermediate Y is this. I am in a matrix for it. So, what are the approaches? One is classical. It didn't come to me. Wait. So classical approach is next slide. So classical approach is Euler-Jones. So we saw how Euler-Jones happens. So deep learning approaches, you get overfit, forget about overfit, it's not so good. So RCNNs we saw. What is RCNN? Randomly generating learning boxes, which is a selective search. Randomly you crop an image and ask the CNN whether it is correct or not. Whether there is object present inside the box or not. Next is fast RCNN, next is YOLO, then comes the master RCNN and SST. So I'll just quickly go forward with what is fast RCNN, what is fast RCNN. So fast RCNN and fast RCNN, okay, you can see RCNN over here. This is the input image. Extract region proposal 2000. That means 2000 voting boxes are drawn in one single image. it is parallelly given, not parallelly, sequentially. If every single image is given to one CNN and ask whether it is right or wrong, and which object is present, whether there is an object present, and next question will be if the object is present, cat or dog, x or y or anything. So this is asking.
One question. So you're talking about ask CNN and all that. Right?
Yeah.
Why don't we use KNN for this?
Now
JNN
is more
right.
Right.
It's a right question.
Right. KNN is a machine learning. What is KNN? KNN is an asking.
Okay.
So what?
Because you are also your main question.
Her point is that whether it is her, actually where she is coming from. I don't know whether it's right thing or not. But the is, KNN also is a classifier. This is also a classifier. So why not
use that?
If you are using a KNN, just think of image. Image is a common pixel. You gonna classify one box. One crop image of that, whether it is cat or dog. One crop image have around so many pixels and you have clustered that box. So KNN will not understand the features inside that.
Sometimes we combine these algorithms. Like in faster RCNN, we do use SVM at the end.
Yes, we
use faster RCNN also we use SVM.
Faster RCNN we use all
that. In the case of KNN, I can say against it is that
how
the corresponding images are not homogeneous. Using all the human organization is
If you see this one KNN, we use it for one dimension, four dimension. But if you consider the image is n dimension. It can be thousand dimension.
And KNN assume that your neighbors also belong to either one class or the class.
Right. So if you have to draw a line, which is n dimensional line, SVM does that. So the final output of this one. So whether it is x or o, so this CNN gives you an output, right? The T0 to that matrix. So one cross some matrix. So which is some eight dimensional or something. For eight dimensional, you can use SVM. What is SVM? SVM is a vector bin. It generates a vector. It chops.
Yeah, it's showing here. See, our CNN. So in the end, we combine SVM. You combine sometimes, you know.
So let's jump forward. So what is this? This is the input image and a recent crop, the 2000 crop image which is given. 2000 images are given to 2000 CNNs and whether it is asked yes or no. So that is what. So here it is asking whether it is the aeroplane person or as a medium of person.
Just a different.
So there is a
lag. No, I put on that, yeah.
Okay. So what is fast RCNN and faster RCNN? So I'll just jump over. So fast, you see RCNN, fast RCNN, faster RCNN. By the name itself, you can say that it is the new algorithm is faster. That's it. So fast RCNN is faster than RCNN. Faster RCNN is faster than faster. The same guy did this. In RCNN, this is the image and the region purposes are crop and this is the crop images are given to CNN. Not provided it is given to 2000 CNNs. That means there is a lot of computation which is happening. CNN just see the computation is happening. So if you are using RCNN for every single image, it detects after 45 seconds or 50 seconds. So 50 seconds computation happens. Why? Because of 2000 CNN computation. So this is the bottleneck break over here. Fast CNN is this 2000 CNN. So this 2000 CNN will be made to one single CNN. shared CNN. Okay. Working is very complex. So just think that one person is doing both those.
So at the same time,
from 49 it drops to 6. So faster thing. If you notice over here, we are generating first results. We are assuming that in the picture, the person can be present in the same. So that's what we can give here. So assuming that the object present over here, and we have to detect this. RCNN or fast RCNN will not work. Yes, right. This velocity process or this bounding process are fixed. Even if it is a 2000, 2000 will not cover this. Rarely some, maybe this one, some part of image can cover this. But
yes, no problem. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Close one.
Yeah.
Okay, see, this is faster CNN. It is giving one single CNN. Instead of multiple 2000 CNN, given over here. Then after that, instead of using, see, in RCNN, the end classification is done through SVM, support vector vision. But over here, you have a softmax and a regressor. So, what is the name of regressor? So next comes the faster RCNN.
So RCNN is a classification problem, and faster RCNN is a regression problem.
No.
Object detection is classification. Is object detection. You classify whether it's X or Y, then you regress the bounding box. You keep moving until it is in the right object, right? That is regression. So there is a classification and regression, which is object detection. So what is the faster RCNN, it generates region proposal directly. It doesn't generate through some selective approach. So faster RCNN happens if image is given over here, sliding day approach. It starts sliding. Every single part, one single filter has been, let us say, some 2 cross 2 or 3 cross 3 resolution is taken. Then image is given over there. The first part, it starts from here, it chops this part. And us classify whether it is right or wrong. It moves whether it is right or wrong, whether it will move or right or wrong. And apart from that, it doesn't only classify the whole image, it starts classifying the part of the views. Let us say there is a sliding window and this one bounding boxes are this present over here. And the classification is for human, for a man. For a man, face is a part of the object. So it detects a face and says it is a man, which is a part of a man. So it understands that somewhere near to this bounding box, the object is present. So it starts regressing. It starts increasing the size in a vertical way or a horizontal way. So this part gets detected. Then once the face is detected, it is a trial and error. So the box starts lengthening or increasing in vertical way and checks whether the next part, the shoulders are present or not. Okay, understood, right? So then it checks whether there is other part of image or something. So it starts regressing. The box starts increasing once the part of image is being detected. Once certain part, that is the whole part is being detected, then it is viewed. So faster RCNN is directly, this part is not there. There is an RP network, region proportional network. So region proportional network generates regions. So that is fast RCNN. Okay.
This is fast RCNN, right?
This is fast RCNN. That is fast RCNN. Fast RCNN, RCNN uses the selective approach.
Fast RCNN.
Fast RCNN. Selective approach. And CNN layer is shared. Instead of using multiple CNN, you are using one single CNN. In a faster CNN, faster RCNN, you are using a single CNN and you are using the RPN network to generate the bounding box. instead of using a select cover approach.
I have some content if you want.
Okay, fine. Yeah, so let's brush up what we spoke. We were speaking about object detection. So object detection is object classification plus localization. So there is a classification and a resolution problem. So you do two tasks at once and you come out with a regular output. So object detection, we understood, it starts from this one, the Euler Jones algorithm. You understand this classical approach, which is R features. R features are those features, which is horizontal, vertical, slant lines. Those are the hard features. So the bilateral algorithm predicts any kind of face through these kind of features. That's what bilateral algorithms uses. So over here, next, the deep learning approach is the neural networks. You're using a neural network to understand higher features or high dimension features, which is better, which is curves or circle or rectangle, those kind of features. So what are the algorithms which is used?
I'm talking about the approaches, right? Right now, I don't know whether this question makes sense. In the interviews now, what is that lazy people use? Is it R10 or 7?
So this is purely related to applications. So all the algorithm works.
No, it works, but
so all algorithm works, but why the new algorithm comes? Because the time was off. So let us say you are just classifying one single picture. How long you wanted one output to take? So RCNN will classify an image. A bounding box will be generated after 45 seconds or 50 seconds. So that means you feed the image output will be back after a minute. RCNN, is that okay for you? Or next is you are using a fast RCNN. So that time the prediction time will be 3 seconds. Are you okay with 3 seconds? But in faster RCNN, you will be getting in around 0.5 seconds, 0.2 seconds. So
what is computation time? Computation power also very good. Like supposing some kind of
computation power is
if you have some amount of GPU, maybe you can only use some algorithm. I'm just asking, I'm
not. No, in the inference way, do we use a GPU in inference?
Yeah, we can use inference may matter less. See, what is I'll tell you something. Faster RCNN was state of the art until recently. Faster RCNN. Because it improved on RCNN and fast RCNN. Faster RCNN was naturally, as the name suggests. But recently, YOLO V3 was published.
Correct.
So YOLO V3 has become the top state of the art now. Now, in terms of computation needs, I'm not exactly sure which one, but most of them need cloud for training. For inference, maybe they can be done on a lighter computer, GPU. No, YOLO V3 is state of the art.
So,
no, faster was better.
His point is actually covered there. Not
just
computation time, but
accuracy. So, faster is superior.
Lot of parameters. So, one is the computation time. It's like if it's train RCNN, it takes days. It takes days, not even hours. It takes days to compute it, even using GPUs. And next is 0.6, which is a time limit. Accuracy is very less. So, as compared to other algorithms, it has a lesser accuracy. When you're going to fast RCNN, it takes days to train. And accuracy is more. Time inference time. Inference is prediction. So prediction is faster, which is 3 seconds. If you go to faster RCNN, even the this one is computation time becomes in the hours. And the prediction time is into 0.2 seconds. Let us say the video is stored. So what is the video? Video is nothing but a sequence of images. So frames per second. So frame per second of any video if you consider will be 30 frames per second, 60 frames per second. Just say 60 frames per second. That means in 1 second, 60 frames, 60 images comes into picture. So you have to predict an image within, if it is 1 second, the 1 second, 0.1 second or 0.6 seconds. Within 0.6 seconds, you have to predict an image. Then only you can generate the bounding box in a video for 60 frames per second. Understood?
Which approach is used in our mobile? Because it detects the image instantly, right?
Wireless. That is
wireless.
So while the zones is a statistical approach, so the computation time is as a matrix would be somewhere around the difference. Image resolution is 1000 nits, it will be 1000 matrix. That's all. So it's just a multiplication. Already matrix is present out there. So it just does a main matrix gets multiplied to our matrix and direct output to the infinite. That is how wireless will come. So inference is very fast.
Even Apple is that. Huh? No. What is that?
They use neural network.
Okay.
See, a mobile equipment is all running in the CPU. So all image processing compared to the algorithm that will run on GPU.
Okay,
yes, that doesn't run on CPU.
Cool.
Most of the algorithm that run on.
Okay, fine. Anyways, let's run through. So, running through, it's like we answered what is this integral network. So, integral image. Integral image is used for wireless. So, that is a very good approach. Forget it. Even if you don't understand, doesn't give anything. So, let's see what is CNN. CNN, what is a CNN? We do convolution. Convolution is a repetitive multiplication of a matrix. So, there will be a filter, and filter will be multiplied to the image, every part of the image. It gets multiplied, and wherever the feature accepts wherever there is a span height, let us say the filter is span height, wherever there is a span height, the values will be more. So wherever there is an opposite span height, the values will be high and it will be negative. So you got the point, the output will be 4, 4, 4, -4, -4, -4 for an x. Understood? So the features are like this. The features can, if you increase the kernel matrix, then you can go for a curve, you can go for a scaling and
full O. Sorry? Full O.
Full O also, but it will become more. I'll come to that piece. So basically, we try to get the parts of image instead of the whole image. You can generate there's some filter which is O itself, and you can directly feed it. But it does not learn anything. Okay? That is why we go for 2x2, 3x3, very small filters. We are not going for some 100x100 filters. We are understanding image part by part. Instead of understanding the whole image, computer, we are making the computer to understand by part by part. That is, so we understood what is CNN. So going forward, classification is done from CNN. Understand the point? Only classification happens in CNN. We have no localization in case of detection. So localization happens to region CNN. This is RCNN, which is generating a boning box. How RCNN works? First is, it generates this one, random boning boxes. If an image is given, randomly it generates boning boxes. What is boning boxes? Nothing but crop images. So random crop images will be given to CNN sequentially. So there will be 2000 boning boxes. So there will be okay. So input image is given over here. First is this one, region proposal happens. What is region proposal? Boundary boxes. Random boundary boxes which is already set. So already we are assuming if the image will happen in center on the right hand side, left hand side, top, bottom, like that. So random bounding boxes are generated, which is 2000, separate 2000, one image is given, 2000 images is being from 2000 images is given to 2000 CNN. 2000 CNN are classified whether it is S or not, object is there or not, S is which object is present. So you got the point, right? So that is our CNN. So
in this case, what happens is 2000 images and one CNN per image.
Yeah.
RCNN is one CNN per image. Right. One CNN per image. Or per crop image.
Yeah, that's right.
Per box, yeah.
In
per
same
box.
Way, you are saying crop image.
Correct.
Yeah, so is it like a working classifier? You have 2000 classifiers, so if there's a.
There is 2000 classifications happening, saying in an image how many objects are there. So you can come to the point, in an image there can be This is multiple images, multiple classification. So faster ascendant can classify maximum of 2000 images. So 2000 objects in an image. In one single image, there can be 2000 objects. Still is a classifier. More than 2000 is not
classifiers only one RCN. Each
classifier will be
either X or Y class.
Or both. X or Y or nothing.
Understood.
So nothing will be avoided. X or Y, both the boxes will be
fair. Then between those X or Y, whichever class is predominant, then the overall image will get that particular class.
That is just the interesting. This the output will be fed in the SPI, then they cross the line. It is X, it is Y. That is fast class. Okay. So this is what is the output you know, right? So output will be like this, whether there is object exists or not. If the object exists, what is which class of object is present? Whether it is in the first class, second class, whether it's a dog or a cat or this one. So that is C1, C2, C3, class 1, class 2, class 3. Which it is there. So if it is, if the object is present, which is what is the dimension of the bounding box?
So one vector captures all those, huh?
Yes, it is there. If it is, if you are considering a two classification problem, the matrix will be 1x8. So this is fixed, this is fixed. So 5 is fixed. So this will be 5 plus the number of classifiers. If you are detecting dog and class, it will become 7. So this dimension varies. This dimension varies, this dimension doesn't change. Understood, right? So going forward, so input is X, output is Y, this Y is fed back again, and a bounding box is drawn to the image, and the output is this given. So bounding box is given. Understood? So this is how it happens. So convolution happens is good. So
actually at the final stage, like what she was saying, you could have used the CNN, but
no, you can use any of them. See, you can customize the ready algorithm, and instead of SVM, you can retrofit CNN.
Correct. We can use anything, but final will be how fast it is, how much accuracy
it is. See, these are pre-trained models, so they have already tried to optimize all possible configurations. So they would have tried instead of SVM every possible classifier, or somehow SVM came out well. So they kept it there. So these are all pre-trained, standard grade models.
Okay.
So we can use them pre-trained model. I don't have to train it away. Just for inference, I can use.
Next is moving to ascendant. So you understood what is ascendant. So what's a cap in ascendant or bottleneck is? There are two CNNs. There are a lot of combinations. This is a lot of cap. So 90% of the computation happens in this 2000 CNN. So the purpose of moving is as the RCNN, we are able to understand this concept, and it was like, yeah, I have to remove this CNN. What if one CNN can do 2000 classification? And then two or what? That's all. So that's what CNN. So he created one convolution, one CNN layer, which can do 2000 classification. 2000 crop images are fed into the CNN. Classification for classifiers output, one CNN will pop out. Okay? So that's what fast ascendant does. So faster ascendants, the time will be, the inference time is faster as compared to ascendant. So next come to YOLO. I'm not going into the YOLO because it is other. So why are you? Next go to faster ascendant. Faster ascendant is faster than faster ascendant. Okay, what is the difference between faster ascendant and fast ascendant?
Almost.
Finals, okay. Inference time is that very fast. If you see in the time movement, it is like 10 times faster than fast passing. And fast passing is again 10 times faster than passing. So if you compare fast passing and passing, then it's 100 times faster. That's how fast it is. So what is faster passing then is? In the RCNN and fast passing, the real proposals are generated. Or assuming that the image is there in center. So this 2000 crop images are fixed. The bounding boxes are fixed. You give any image, the bounding boxes are the same. Location is the same. So cos of secant is alpha. So first is one RTM network is there, when an image is being fed, then upon that there is a CNN layer there, then upon that there is a classifier, then upon that is a regressor. I'll tell you what. So input is being given away. You guys can see right. So when an input is given, first is RPN. RPN is region proposal network. How this works is, if an image is given over here, a filter side or one, it's called a kernel. Kernel is some dimension you take. Okay, 3x3 or 2x2. So some 2x2 or something, this part is being taken and it starts seeing over the image, scanning over the image. Goes over here, drops down, comes down, then drops down, goes over here. Sliding in the upwards. This is called sliding in the upwards. So it starts scanning the image. So you know how the rocks machine works, right? Start from the starting, start scanning through it, and generate the output. So same thing, it starts scanning and starts checking. So for every scan, it's fed. If let us say this part is being scanned, it is fed into CNN, and it classifies whether it is object is or not. Then after that, whether if it is object is there, then it is fed into a regressor to generate the x and y coordinates of the body codes. Okay. So what is regressor? I'll tell you why. So it's like how it happens. So once it is there, one part of image will be detected. Then this part is given over here, and the expert regressor is start increasing. The body boxes start elongating, so that we cover the whole image. Okay, that is regressor.
Yeah, one thing. So if you are doing like a sequential operation like this one, like sliding over an element, so it will take time consuming, right?
No, this detects part of image. It still understands the part of the image, not the whole image.
No, but what if you are saying is like sliding over the kernel, means the small kernel, sliding over the total image. So I'm doing that is happening in sequential order, right? So
no, then happens in parallel. Because CNN is a shared CNN. Shared CNN. Don't think like every input is being fed one after another. It is fed parallel.
Okay.
This whole image is there, right? Okay. Just think this whole image split into 2000. Split into 2000 pieces and split. Okay, given to the CNN. And depending on the output, so it starts correlating, like, start collecting all the boxes which are being. Okay, fine. Let us say the input is X. For the training, we ourselves will draw bounding boxes. Bounding boxes will be drawn, and this is the input to be given. So, if this input is given over here, every single part is given to CNN. Okay, let us say this part is fed. There is something called IO input. So, intersection of IO input. You can ask how this happens. How this happens is, so let us say this part is fed into CNN. CNN says that this is the part of X. It says there is object or not. It says there is object. There is a one part of X present over here. It says object. Once it is there, it checks the training data is this is the box. So this is the original box, required box, and this one, our regressor RPM is generating this. So how much is the intersection? You know, see, ZP, right? How much is the intersection? So just think, this is some 100, this is some, so I'm considering the intersection is somewhere around 10%. 10% is covered. So at over union, what is the union means? This is additional to this. This is 100%, and this is a small box, so it can be some 20% or something. So if you consider this box over this box, it is 20%. Understood, right? So this will be 120%. So this gives an IOI value. What this says is our regression happens such that this IOI starts increasing. The upper limit starts increasing until this 100% happens. Until intersection over union, this is the predicted image. Until we get the regular bounding box, which is equivalent to this, if you are doing like if the body box and the prediction value both the same, then the output will be 100/100. Correct? Got the point, right? So I know you tells you how much percent you are near the actual value, actual body box. That's where the regression comes into picture. You start increasing. So when this body box is there, 20% is there, it starts expanding itself. So when it starts expanding to this level, IOU will increase. When it starts expanding to this side, IOU will increase. So it is off. When it starts increasing to this level, again IOU will increase. This level, IOU will decrease.
We use the regression to show the accuracy of the class. So the accuracy of the class.
Again, it's a gradient. If you plot again, it will become a gradient. So it knows which direction it should do. It should regress. From this side, it should regress in the right level and the left level. I mean, bottom level. So if you are going
at that point to point, this thing is unusual.
So this point, when it starts going to this side, then IOU start increasing until unless IOU becomes 1. This is how it understands.
I'm lost over here. You were talking about the IOU part of it, that is the intersection part.
Intersection over union.
Correct. So you are something you were talking about the sliding also, right? So the question came in that since you said it's going to be a sequel, a sliding frame. So is it a sequential?
No, it's not a sequential. It's a shared CNN.
It's a shared CNN. So when it is a shared CNN, you're talking about
1% does 2% classification.
Okay. So that's why you're talking about is the intersection is 100% or not?
Exactly. How much part of image belongs to the Y? Okay. So that's what they're saying.
The intersection over union mathematically means the boundary box intersection boundary box intersection with the entire interplane. One boundary box union with the entire plane.
So position, whether it is 100% correct position or whether it is already 20% correct position. We are determining the position. So that's what
one question. So you also told there's a sliding window happening in the open picture. And also you added that there would be some 2,000 frames right at a time.
But
2,000
how is this it's not different, right? I mean 2,000 frames would be generated. If that is the case, then why would sliding window come into
one more, one more, one more. Okay, fine. So how arcane works, I will tell you. So there are multiple, let us say this can be 2 cross 2. Okay, 2 cross 2. Next will be 3 cross 2. Next will be 2 cross 3. So this kind of variation can happen. That's what I am showing here. So just think, the bounding box will be 2 cross 2, 3 cross 2, 2 cross 3. 3 cross 2 will have 2 cross 2. This belongs to this. Correct, right? So if you consider this combination, there will be some 64 lakh combination for one single image.
Okay.
By avoiding the intersections, 3 cross 2 will have 2 cross 2. So I don't require 2 cross 2 in that case. So by avoiding these kind of combination, you will get 2,000. I don't know 2,000. That's why 2k crop images. So let us say I'm putting 2 cross 2 over here. The position is 2 cross 2 here. I don't need to put a 3 cross 2 here because there is no requirement. I'll put a 3 cross 2 over here. Understood? And I will not put a 2 cross 3 here. I'll put a 2 cross 3 here. So I am avoiding this kind of combination. So if you are avoiding those kind of combination there, to one filter or another filter are overlapping. When you are avoiding the overlapping, you come into a conclusion of 2,000 images, not 2,000 to 6,000 images. That's what the point. Got the point?
Okay.
Again, I'll tell you.
No, if that is the case, then why are we using slightly from the concept? You told me this is sliding the
okay.
I mean, how
okay. Also, these were related. Yeah, I understand. N cross N. This is the image which I am choosing. I am choosing the first filter. This is
okay.
2 cross 2. I start the filter. 2 cross 2. Okay. I start moving. Till this part N. There is. So let us say 2 cross 2 and then 10 cross 10. You will get around how many?
5 times.
5 times and 10 over here. So around 25 times. So the total times is 25. Okay. Right? So when I am using 2 cross 3, 2 cross 3 will be
less than
25. Less than 25. Somewhere around 20. Something 20 or something. Then you will use the 3 cross 2. Again it will become 20. 20. The total is somewhere around 65. 65. But 65 is including overlap. So if 2 cross 2 is there, then it's just 2 cross 3. 2 cross 3 will come again here. This is redundant, useless. So the combination is not required because there is an overlap. So when I'm putting 2 cross 3, I'll put over here. This is 2 cross 3. Again 3 cross 2. 3 cross 2 I'll not put here. I'll put over here. 3 cross 2. So there is no overlap happening. I'll answer your question how the sliding upwards happens. So sliding up happens is, let us say I'm doing sequentially filter size. So every filter I'm putting next to next. So 2 cross 2 is first is here. The next combination will occur over here. It will not happen here. That is the sliding window.
It will skip the next one because I want to say.
These pixels will be skipped and it will go here.
Okay.
So you mean to say all those bounding boxes will be there previously only because of the selective versus.
No, it is not selective, it is random.
Oh, random. And it is your explaining the concept of faster RPM, right?
All is same image, 10 plus 10 is there. 10 cross 10 is given. First, I am taking a small perspective, which is 2 cross 2. I am seeing over here. Object is there or not. It is saying it is there. Then, this part of image is important. So, this 2 cross 2 will become 2 cross 3. Then, again, I am asking whether it is there or not. If it is yes, then it will start expanding. So, before expanding, I will tell you. So, let us say if it is not there, they are saying it is not there. So, 2 cross 3 feature is waste. So, it is not there. Then again, it will not become 2 cross 2, it will become 3 cross 2. And check whether it is there or not. So, 3 cross 2 will have adopted. Understood? So, this is how it happens. So starts with a small 2 cross 2, then becomes 2 cross 3, then 3 cross 2, then if 3 cross 2 is there, then start regressing again. So 2 cross 2 gets added again, then I can 3 cross 2. So that's how the sliding will approach.
That means sliding is going to happen 2 by 2. So it is the
sliding window and combination will confuse. So sliding window, that means it's from the start level, from the top left. Top right or
keep on increasing.
So from top left it starts and it starts regressing. So it starts sliding to bottom right. Okay, this is faster RCM and this is
software
is something very fast. So, RCNN uses SDM, which is a support vector machine, to classify at the last level. So, once the 2000 CNN gives output, the output should be classified whether it is X or Y. So,
The question to SVM to do this task. When it moving into fast RCM and faster RCM, you are using a soft mass. Soft mass will give you probability of x and y. How much probability is given to x, how much probability is given to y? If you notice, some body boxes will have accuracy saying that, it is not there in that image video. So, some videos are all, if you see, this bounding box is a person and some percentage values will be given. So, that is fast and faster RCM and use also. So, it uses a soft mass in that case. So, classification and localization gives you detection. So in the classification is image, output level, whether it is which class it is present, losses, softmax loss, which is cross entropy loss, not all that. Evolution matrix is accuracy, how accurate it is. Localization is input is image, output is the box, the bounding boxes, which is x and y coordinates and width and height coordinates. And loss over here is L2 level, which is Euclidean distance. Euclidean distance is the distance from the y dash and y, how far it is or how near it is to the actual value. That is what evolution matrix is, intersection over union. How much it is overlapping the, how much it is to the actual value, how much it is near to the actual value, that is IOU. So classification and localization, if you compare, so loss will be the sum of both the losses. Output will be the class level plus the x and y coordinates of the law. Okay. So when you know the difference between different overall what is that? So application coding level is key. So code, everything is available on internet. So understand the code. How do you use the code? How do you utilize? There are some ideas also there. How do you utilize that with
this? Bouncing.
Okay, so this is IOU. So intersection over union. So intersection, how much it is near. So if you notice over here, it is somewhere on, I say that 90% accuracy is accurate. So 90% of the box is covered. So I think this one loss is 10%. Loss is the metric over here. IOU. Okay, that's what the main I wanted to say is this one. So what does you want to understand? Okay, this I'll show you. Same one.
Sorry.
Okay. So, if you notice over here, we are using the same image. I said the line, for example, the line. So, if the face is given over here, so body is given over here. How the vertical? That if you consider the slant features, slant lines. You notice this image. So, the where are the position where the slant lines are present? So this filter will give that. Okay. So this is human. This is showing where are the slant features. So these are the slant features. If you are convolving or deconvolving into only the slant features, this is the output. If you are going for a hidden feature, more hidden feature is as of some straight and straight convolution. So you are getting a little bit curves. Then if you are going more deeper, you are identifying the places where the path of the object are there. So this part. You can see this face, this is the hand, this is the car, leg or something like that. Yeah, so that's what it is detecting. These are the hidden features which are learned from neural network, deep neural network, not from the wireless network. So yeah, from the face when it is deconvolved, this is the output you will get. How these features, the straight features, the horizontal line, vertical line, and the slant line as used, or is this when you deconvolve the face into that? So use cases will come here. The use cases are, there are multiple use cases are there. When you want to detect a face or an object or anything. So going forward, object detection is one of the way. Apart from that, there is something called segmentation also. Segmentation is you're fine with like okay, there is an input. So these are the applications for object detection. Segmentation is you know there is an image over here, there is a bounding box also there, but you don't want the bounding box, you want to segment only the object. So you draw a line over the object and segment it. That is image segmentation.
Yeah, but the approach is used in Google Lens. I mean, they also detect an image. If you just take a photo and they can tell you that what exactly the thing is. So they use these one of these photos.
Yeah,
right. Which one is that? Do we have?
They will be using same elbows, right? I mean, they wrote most of these elbows, right?
Yeah.
Google
So they would be using all these algos only, whether it's Google Translate for language translation, Google Lens for object detection. They will be using.
So because sometimes object detection is like the if let's say the camera is ready, there is an object, so it will apply a brake or something. So avoid an object, avoid. Can do all object. If you are doing this object segmentation, you can know where exactly the object is. Let us say that it is the camera is detecting object is there, but what is the shape of the object so that I can avoid. So when you have a shape of the object, I can ride over it. The car. So if you see how curvy the road is, so that how much turn you should take. So those can be applied through segmentation.
So object segmentation, it is not part of classification localization detection. It is the next thing.
You classify object, you localize the object, then after that you localize in a perfect way. So instead of bounding box, you draw the curves of the object. If a road is you are detecting, then what are the curvature of the road? How the road is in? That is the segmentation. So that's the end part of the segmentation. To going forward, so you understand how the techniques work. So be the general user TensorFlow or something. For everything there is an API. RCNN there is an API. For everything there is an API. So you just RCNN, you feed in all the parameters. You feed X, then you feed other Y2 parameters which are required, then you get Y. And from Y, you feed into the again the image. So the image will be the body box will be drawn on the image and the image part. Output image will be fit. That's all. Evaluation is image. So we'll be having image, which is 2% improvement, use that and then so image across all the classes, mean or average over all the classes will give you the model accuracy. Depending on the use case, you can use any kind of algorithm. What is relevant? So that's what this precision is. Precision is how much part of the output is used or useful. So that's what it says. We call this how many items are submitted. Okay, any doubts or something you can just around? Any doubts or something? Ask. And the topic name is something that takes you. So then you don't go away. These are all the mathematical equations which are used for accuracy loss. Good.
Any
doubts? Any? There was a one.
Clear. Clear.